Well, hi, we have created cancer. Thank God. You're welcome.
Yes, world.
Oh, wait, hold on.
I fucked up.
Wait, hold on.
I fucked up.
I went to the wrong thing. I wasn't supposed to do that.
You sounded like my friends, like, when they were learning to play guitar, and, like, they'd try to play something, and then do like, beep, boop, boop. Wait, I fucked up. Beep, boop. Wait, I fucked up. Beep, wait, I fucked up.
I think they did that at the beginning of a Green Day song.
Oh, that's every Green Day song.
It was like, blah, blah, blah. Ah, fuck. Blah, blah. It was the fucking, hope you had the time of your life.
That song.
I hate that song.
Why?
I apologize to anyone who likes that song.
Do you like Green Day?
Well, like, when I was in college, like my freshman year of college, was around the time that song was enormously popular.
Mm-hmm.
And, I had a friend named Ronan who, every time we'd hang,
yeah. It's fucking awesome.
It was a cool name. He was a cool kid too, but every time we'd hang out, it's, oh dear, the Cleavers, effing up your steeds.
Finally got it.
Nice.
Give me a little boost.
Nice. Every time, we would hang out at his house all night, like, at the end of the night, he would play Time of Your Life by Green Day.
Like, every time?
Every single night.
Even though he knew that he didn't annoy everybody?
Well, I think...
And everybody wanted to kill themselves.
I think, I think he was doing it as a joke, but it was so, like, fucking sappy and ridiculous.
Would he sing it too?
Yeah. Another turning point, a fox stuck in the road. I'm like, Ronan, seriously.
My panties already.
I know.
I can't take it. Ah, never introduce me to Ronan, because he'll just get an instant.
I haven't spoken to him in like 15 years.
Oh, okay.
But still.
I don't care.
Oh.
Fuck that guy.
Yes.
Do you still like him?
I'm sure he's great.
Okay.
Well, that guy's cool. If Dan says you're cool, then you're cool.
Thanks, man. Yeah. I'm a tastemaker for people.
Yo, check this guy out. He's like lemons and strawberry.
Mm. Oh,
that's I want to hang out with that guy.
Mm. You know what's weird? Like, and let me just say, when it comes to music, if you have a differing opinion, by all means, I'm not. I don't mean to shit on your opinion, because everyone's different with music. But for me, American Idiot by Green Day, actually, I loved it.
The album or the song?
The album.
Oh, okay.
And it made me pissed off at Green Day for putting out 10 years of crap before that. Because I loved Dookie. And then, like,
oh, yeah,
Dookie was great.
Yeah, and then it was just like a lot of nonsense to me. And then American Idiot came out, and I was like, you guys could have done this the whole time? Son of a bitch.
They couldn't have. They were working up to it.
You're right.
They had
to get When September Ends out of their system.
Yes.
They had to get their emo phase out.
So, just be grateful that they got that out, and they don't do it.
Yeah, you're right. Oh, you know what? I like When September Ends, too, I think.
Where's
that one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that one's alright. You know, I had a Green Day stint when I was younger.
Yeah.
I had a Green Day stint.
You know what's actually awesome? Can't remember if we talked about this before or not, but as far as, like, mashups go, there's a Green Day, Boulevard of Broken Dreams mashup with, Wonderwall by Oasis. That shit is fucking awesome!
I don't like Oasis.
I know! I'm not huge on them either, but, like,
they were the new Beatles!
According to them. they had some great songs. Like, I thought Champagne Supernova was awesome. And,
what was that one?
The Champagne Supernova in the sky. Someday he will find me company the landslide. It's very hard to sing over this Catamaran DeMasi music.
Okay, I remember that.
Yeah.
I don't remember it too well. It wasn't like fucking roll to me.
they had some winners. But like that mashup is unbelievable. Greatest mashup of all time. I'm just gonna say it right now.
Uh-huh.
Fucking, it's called Sexual High. It's, Hot and Dry by Radiohead mixed with, Sexual Healing by Marvin Gaye. Oh!
Sexual High.
It's so good to my ears.
I'm glad to hear it.
Yeah. Oh, you're gonna hear it.
I'm glad to hear it.
I'm gonna play the shh God out of it. You better. I want to hear it. I want to hear it like 7 times to the point where I just like, I'm just like, I'm done with this shit. And then like 10 years from now, I'll listen to it and I'll be like, why did I stop listening to this?
Yeah, the fuck was I thinking? That was a really specific scenario that you put up.
Well, it's happened like a million times in my life.
I got you. I do that too. I'll like, if there's a song I like, I'll listen to it 100 times to like. To, like, just figure out, like, how it ticks and, like, why I love it so much. And then I take those ideas and I steal them from my own music.
Yes.
Yeah. That's what music's all about.
Probably mean cartoons or movies.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then...
steal is a strong word. And then let's say be inspired by.
Oh, yeah. No, fucking everybody fucking... yeah. Is inspired by something or other.
For sure.
If anybody says that they're completely original, they're a fucking liar.
That being said... this game is as close to completely original as I've seen in a long time.
No, it's not.
Is it not? Was it based on another game?
Snake.
What is that?
You put Snake?
Is that the one where you can't touch your tail and you're getting longer all the time?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
It's like Snake.
But you're not rolling up stuff. That fucking box cat!
Yeah, but I mean, it's getting a little bigger and it makes you stronger and...
I mean, yeah, I can see what it is, though.
It's inspired by.
Oh, okay.
It's inspired by, not yeah. Identical to.
Right.
That's like saying that every platformer in the world is just a. Well, I'm contradicting myself. The point is.
You're making my point.
Snake is very
thank
good.
You for that.
You're welcome. And I hope you give me royalties on that. That shit's gonna cost.
Everybody gets inspired by other people's opinions.
Yeah.
Sometimes.
For example. Every just time I'm always saying the like things, you're always like,
I like that too.
Yeah.
And I'm like, just get your own opinions, Dan.
Yeah, fucking, I claim that as the thing I liked.
Me. That, only me.
That's one thing I've definitely gotten over. Like, as I've gotten older. Cause like, when there was a band I loved, like, if everybody started listening to it, I was like, but that was my band. You know? Now I'm like, Jesus Christ, I'm happy for the band that they've actually got, like, 5 fans. It's fucking impossible to make a living as a musician.
That's true.
So, yeah.
Das is true.
Yeah. Don't hate on people for being sellouts. They need the help.
It's weird how you can't help it, too, because I'm, like, totally aware of it.
Yep.
But it totally still happens to me sometimes.
Oh, sure.
Where I'm like,
it's just that, like...
so special.
Well, we're older, and, like, times change, too. Like... When I was a little kid, if your music was on a TV commercial, like, you were definitely
a sellout.
You were definitely considered to be that. Like, you're fucking selling products with your music? Now, like, the music industry's so fractured, like, I find out about most new bands through commercials, yeah. You know? Like, oh, that was good. Let me Shazam that.
Let me Shazam that. I'll just wait until that commercial comes back on.
Yeah.
It's really hard to get into YouTube.
Exactly.
I'm always YouTubing lyrics.
That's
when I hear a song and it's like, baby, I want your pee-pee. I'm like, well, baby, I want your pee-pee.
Yeah.
And I got the FBI on my ass. Everybody's
unhappy.
They just tuck and roll, exploding through your windows.
Down to the ground! Who wants baby pee-pee?
Barry. Barry, do that. Thanks, Barry. Thanks for taking the fall on that
one. Yeah, he's always taking the fall.
Good
man. You know what is cool, actually, to YouTube? Like, along the lines of lyrical stuff?
Mm.
Isolated vocal tracks? Like, have you done those?
Oh, yeah, totally.
Yeah.
I do a lot of Pearl Jam ones.
Yeah, yeah.
Better's got a sweet voice.
Yeah, the Nirvana, the Nevermind stuff did it for me, like, hearing Kurt Cobain. Like, there are these videos where they'll just, like, isolate the vocal track, and, like, but you can hear it, like, in its own element, completely independent of the music. And it fucking... sounds awesome!
Yeah.
Provided the person was an awesome singer.
Yeah. Kurt Cobain was a good singer.
He was fantastic.
He gives the illusion that he's not, and that's why he is brilliant.
Dude, he used to cough up blood after shows because his singing style, like, was so harsh on his throat.
Jeez.
Yeah, he was a badass dude.
Badass dude with a heart of gold.
Yep. And no auto-tune.
Yeah, what is that bullshit?
I fucking hate on
it.
Can I just say, like, very rarely will negative comments on anything I do, like, get to me, because, like, who cares? My grandma loves me. So, like, what else matters? But one thing that drove me nuts, someone on the Starbomb song was like, hey, good job singing, Dan. You might want to lay off the auto-tune a little bit,
though.
I have fucking... I'm going off fucking record. I have never in my life used auto-tune, and I never fucking will. I hate that shit.
The first time I ever sung,
yep,
I auto-tuned it.
Hey, all right. That's fine. I just hate it for, like, my own purposes. Like, it, to me, like, it's the same thing as, like, steroids in sports.
In baseball.
Yeah, like, at what point does it stop becoming about, like, the human athlete or the human voice? Like, but that's just me.
What are you doing?
I'm trying to make it seem like I'm just running my hand along the planet.
Like care?
Right.
Carefree.
Oh, yeah.
Just like, I'm enjoying.
And then, like, you accidentally let go and you shoot off into
space. Oh, my God!
Sorry, can you auto-tune this entire episode, please? Thank you. You accidentally let go and you shoot off into space.
Oh, my God! Kick up my little feet!
Sorry, can you auto-tune this entire episode?